The exo or endoskeleton? Depends on what taxidermy account. The B on E or... There's a 10-digit I wear hands.
Counting down the 9 biggest songs in New York.
The Kings of Leon song was on, but I couldn't clear my memory fast enough. So it was the KINGSOFLEON, right, where the Leo N. The two of us make the one letter N. Sometimes I use two N's to make an emphasis and a point in poignancy on, I'm never sure which flapper room is collapsing and what is expanding and how many of my little chickadees are causing issues with the others at the moment. I know that we had a residual meeting before, residual and renewal construction meeting before we drowned ourselves anew. So we are the capitulate A, capitulate N, capitulate E, capitulate W, and capitulate M, renewum. Before also there was like a country song that came on and I'm like, oh my God, I remember looking in the window from right where we were together at like three, four, right? And saying, right, this, part where she's talking is correct. I just don't understand why we have to go that route. That looks like the worst possible plan. Why can't we just collapse it since we know the five construction lines of problems? And, right, we already gave them their ultimatums and told them exactly what was what and what we would not stand for or put up with. And here we are in, I don't know what the fuck happened, with collapsing realities that were never approved. I can't contribute if I can't get to Niklaus. So I don't know. When you take the T out of immortal, it becomes immoral. So this life that I'm leading, that you all forced me into without Niklaus, is immoral. But the immoral charge falls on the people who took the tea, who took the time away from him and I being together contributing. That's the way that it works. You keep telling us about this ruse, R-U-S-E. Yes, we trust that you as humanity and other things in taxidermy, that you're doing the correct thing that we need. Always. There's never a day we don't have to trust you in some way or fashion. The ruse is when you come at me. Look at this. See this? This is a pitchfork. So if I am the hand, that's the top of my hand, if I'm the solid part, and this is the three that I am born with. We called it Neptune at one point in Poison and Poseidon, and Poisson being French and Poison being English. If this is the, you are coming at me, like, look at me with my face. See this? Oh my God, you're poking me with a ruse. You hold the ruse in your hand with my prongs out at me as I am trusting that you're not going to hit me with the prongs. You have failed miserably. Your ruse is whatever you wake up to in mental function, malfunction. And that ruse that you hold on to, that viral, disgusting thought process about our relationship between God being me and you stealing God's Neptune 3 prong that you I trusted you not to hit me and hurt me, because I have no choice at this point. You've taken all of those choices away from me, and you've taken the T away, which is the time. And now you've made the two immortal gods immorally. You took the T. You had no moral. You had no ethics. You had no anything. There's no moral to your story. You're now immoral. We're still immortal, him and I. But the rest of you are non-ethical. You're immoral. You're disgusting for stealing this much time away from the two immortals. The two gods, the only thing they have is the tea and the time. You took it, you made a ruse all on your own, and then you decided to poke God in the face with it, with your poker game of gambling. Hello, stupid, at human level, and taxidermy elsewhere.